In this video, we're going to start the Multiplying Special Case Polynomials free worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Now our directions are to find each product, and we're multiplying special case polynomials. And there are three special case polynomials that will be present in this worksheet. We'll have a plus b times a minus b. And that will always be a squared minus b squared. We will also see a plus b and that binomial squared. That will always be a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. And lastly, we will see a minus b and that binomial squared. So essentially, a minus b times a minus b. Just as a plus b squared is a plus b times a plus b. So this is a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. So the only difference between these last two is that this is a plus, so we're adding 2ab, and where this is a minus, we're subtracting 2ab. So let's get started with number one. In number one, we have a plus b times a minus b. So this is going to be a squared minus b squared. Our a is equal to x, and our b is equal to 5. So for a squared minus b squared, we'll have x squared minus 5 squared, which is x squared minus 5 times 5, which is 25. So number one, our solution is x squared minus 25. In number two, we have a minus b times a plus b. This is the same as a plus b times a minus b. It's going to equal a squared minus b squared. Our a is n and our b is 1. So a squared minus b squared will equal n squared minus 1 squared. And 1 squared is simply 1, since 1 times 1 is 1. So n squared minus 1 is the solution in number 2. In number 3, we have a minus b and that binomial squared. So remember, that's a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. In this case, our a is equal to p and our b is equal to 1. So plugging that in, we'll have p squared minus 2 times p times 1, since b is 1, plus 1 squared. So that's equal to p squared minus 2 times p times 1 is 2p, and we're adding 1 squared, which is 1. P squared minus 2p plus 1 is our solution in number 3. In number 4, we're back to a minus b times a plus b, which will be a squared minus b squared. Our a, in this case, is x, and our b is 3. So a squared minus b squared will be x squared minus 3 squared, and x squared minus 3 squared simplified as x squared minus 9. And that's the solution in number 4. In number 5, we have a minus b and that binomial squared. So that's a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. Our a in this case is x and our b is 4. So plugging x in for a, we'll get x squared minus 2 times x, and plugging 4 in for b, so that's 2 times x times 4 plus 4 squared. Simplifying that polynomial, we'll get x squared minus 2 times 4, which is 8, times x, plus 4 squared, which is 16. So x squared minus 8x plus 16. In number 6, we see a plus b and that quantity squared. That's going to be a squared plus 2 times a times b plus b squared. Our a is n, and our b is 3. So plugging n for a and b in a squared will be n squared plus 2 times a times b will be 2 times n times b, which is 3. And we're adding that to b squared, which is 3 squared. That's going to give us n squared plus 2 times 3 times n will be 2 times 3, which is 6 times n plus 3 squared, which is 9. N squared plus 6n plus 9. And number 7, a minus b times a plus b equals a squared minus b squared. Our a is x and our b is 5. So that's going to be x squared minus 5 squared, which is x squared minus 25, which is the same as we got in number 1. In number 1, we had x plus 5 times x minus 5, and in number 7, since multiplication is commutative and we can multiply in any order, we multiplied x minus 5 times x plus 5 and got the same answer, x squared minus 25. For number 8, we have a minus b squared. Our a is n and our b is 5. So plugging n for a and plugging 5 in for b, for a squared minus 2ab plus b squared, we'll have n squared minus 2 times n times 5 plus 5 squared. That equals n squared minus 2 times 5 is 10 times n plus 5 squared is 25. N squared minus 10n plus 25. And number 9, we have a plus b and that quantity squared. So we'll have a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. Our a, in this case, is 2k squared. And our b is 1. So you can see, as opposed to having a single variable, a is the term 2k squared. So plugging 2k squared in for a, we'll get 2k squared squared plus 2 times 2k squared times b, which is 1, plus 1 squared. 2k squared squared is 2k squared times 2k squared, which is 4k to the fourth. So 4k to the fourth plus 2 times 2k squared is 4k squared times 1 is 4k squared. And we're adding that to 1, since 1 squared is 1. So 4k to the fourth plus 4k squared plus 1 is the solution in number 9. In number 10, we have a plus b times a minus b. So that's going to be a squared minus b squared. Our a in this case is 8a squared. And our b is equal to 4. So for a squared minus b squared, we'll have 8a squared squared minus b squared, which is 4 squared. 8a squared squared is 8a squared times 8a squared, which will be 64a to the fourth, and we're subtracting 4 squared, which is 16. So 64a to the fourth minus 16 is the solution in number 10. In number 11, we have a plus b and that polynomial squared. So that's a squared plus 2 times a times b plus b squared. So a is 2 and b is 5n squared, this entire term. 2 and then 5n squared. So plugging 2n for a, we'll get 2 squared plus 2 times 2 times b, which is 5n squared. And then adding b squared, which is 5n squared squared. So 2 squared is 4, and we're adding that to 2 times 2, which is 4, times 5, which is 20, times n squared, which is 20n squared, and that gets added to 5n squared, squared, so 5n squared, times 5n squared, which is 25n to the fourth. So the polynomial number 11 is 4 plus 20n squared plus 25n to the fourth. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 12. But before I work through this answer, please subscribe to my channel and give me a thumbs up. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. And number 12, we have a minus b times a plus b. So this is going to be a squared minus b squared. Our a, in this case, is 3x. And our b, in this case, is 7. So plugging 3x in for a, we'll get 3x squared. And remember, it's that entire term squared. So this 3x will get squared. And we're subtracting b, which is 7 squared. So 3x squared is going to be 3x times 3x, which is 9x squared. And we're subtracting 7 times 7, which is 49. So 9x squared minus 49 is the solution and number 12. And just remember, so you don't get tripped up, that we're squaring that entire term. So it's not just 3x squared, it's the quantity 3x squared. So the exponent will have to get distributed to the 3 and to the x, not just to the x. And with that, we wrap up this video. Join me in the next video where I'll complete the worksheet, finishing problems numbers 13 through 26. And if you haven't already, click that subscribe button.